Welcome to the next level of VR. Oculus Quest is an all-in-one virtual reality gaming system that allows you to play untethered in room-scale VR. Transport yourself to a new world. Battle against friends in combat. Or to the beat. Share your victories for all to see. Fight robots. Slow time. Find your rhythm. Blast drones. And more. Learn how with the following video series. Welcome to the Oculus Quest tutorial series. In this video, we'll show you how to properly set up your account and device for the first time. First, open up the box and remove the contents. You'll find a head-mounted display, charger, charging cord, glasses lens spacer, reference guide, safety and warranty guide, and two controllers with two AA batteries. Also, keep your eyes out for additional accessories available on the Oculus website. Next, download the Oculus smartphone app from either the Google Play or Apple App Store. You won't need your smartphone every time you use the device, but you will need one for the initial setup. Once you've installed the app, open it up and you'll see a login screen. If you don't already have an account, you can create one using your email address or your Facebook account. Logging in through Facebook is recommended because it'll allow you to easily find and add friends and share content. Games and apps you download will be linked to your account. That way your purchases will be safe even if something happens to your headset. Once you've logged in, the app will take you to the privacy settings screen, where you can manage settings to control how people can search for you, who can see your friend list, and more. If this is your first time logging into the Oculus app, it will automatically prompt you to choose a headset to begin the setup process. Click on the Start button, and the app will direct you through four easy steps to pair the headset. First, plug your Oculus Quest into the charger. Then, make sure your headset is turned on. If it's not on, you can turn it on by pressing and holding the power button for 2 seconds. Once it's on, take a look in the headset for a 5-digit code. Type this code into the app, and the headset will begin to pair with the app. Once the step is complete, select a Wi-Fi network. Now it's time to pair the controllers. Put one of the provided batteries in each controller. Hit Next, and the app will connect to both controllers. If they aren't connected right away, the app will prompt you to pair each one individually. Hold the Menu button and the Y button to pair your left controller. Once the light starts blinking, hit Continue, and follow the same steps for the right controller. This time, holding the Oculus button and B button. Next, you'll be prompted to add a payment method. The payment method will be used later for downloading apps and games. Then, you'll be shown a short video on how to use your Oculus Quest safely. Once you've watched the video and acknowledged the health and safety warning, congratulations! You've just successfully set up your Oculus Quest. While you wait for the software installation to complete, here's an important note on how to properly wear your headset so that the picture is clear and the headset is comfortable. First, make sure the back straps cradle the base of your head. Then, adjust the straps and move the headset up and down until it's resting comfortably on your face. Finally, adjust the toggle on the bottom left of the headset until the picture is clear. You'll know you're wearing the headset correctly when it's resting lightly on your face and the picture appears clearly. Remember, your Oculus Quest will go to sleep if the sensor above the lenses is not covered. That's how the headset knows you're wearing it. Oculus Quest frees you to enjoy VR untethered. You can play games in room scale with the ability to walk around in the play area or in stationary mode, standing or sitting in one place. Your space and preference will dictate which mode works best for you. First, let's clear out a play area. Room scale works best with 6.5 by 6.5 feet of space or larger. Once you've cleared as much room as possible, put on the headset to begin Guardian setup. Remember to always wear your touch wrist straps when in VR. When putting on the headset for the first time, you should see what we call pass-through. Pass-through is a new Oculus feature which allows you to take a quick look at the outside world to help you get oriented in space while wearing the device. Pass-through is essential in creating your play area. The first step in pass-through is to calibrate tracking by setting the floor. To calibrate and set the height of the floor, gently place your controller on the ground and look at it. You should see a virtual grid appear near the floor. Once the grid is correctly locked at floor height, hit continue. Next, it's time to define your play area. Defining your play area will help Guardian notify you if you start to move outside of it. Point the controller at the ground and use the trigger button on the controller to trace a play area. Be sure to leave extra space between the play area and your walls, furniture, and other obstructions. You can skip this step if you don't want to walk around in VR and just want to use Oculus Quest in a stationary seated or stationary standing position. Once you hit continue, you'll see the blue Guardian boundary tracing your play area. You'll get a warning if you get too close to the edge of this area or step outside. Check that this boundary is correctly positioned and clear of any obstructions. If Guardian is not drawn correctly, or you want to change the boundary, click the back arrow to restart the Guardian setup. To keep your Oculus Quest operating at peak performance, here are some things you should know. It's important that you keep direct sunlight away from the headset. The sun's rays can cause permanent damage to the lenses and screen inside. Don't place it near a window or anywhere direct sunlight can hit the lens. When cleaning your headset, be sure not to use alcohol or an abrasive cleaning solution. They could damage the device. The inside of the Oculus Quest headset can be cleaned with non-abrasive antibacterial wipes. You can always refer to the support articles on the app or the Oculus website for more details on device care. Modifying the headset to work with glasses using the provided glasses spacer is easy. Your glasses frames are compatible if they're smaller than 142 millimeters wide and 50 millimeters in height. To insert the glasses spacer, gently remove the facial interface foam. Then attach the glasses spacer to the back of the facial interface with the glasses logo on top. Press it into place. Then reinsert the facial interface foam back into place. That's it. Oculus Quest offers a wide variety of VR experiences to discover. Here's how to find and download them. In VR, the home menu will help you find recommended content or select Store to see all available games and apps. Once you download something, you can always find it in your library. All of your purchases are linked to your account, so you'll never lose anything, even if something happens to your headset. Here are some tips on how to use the controller properly. To make a selection in VR, hover your pointer over your selection and click the A button. If you want to reorient your play area, face in the direction you'd like to set as forward, and hold down the Oculus button on the right controller for 3 seconds. To quit out of a game or application, simply press the Oculus button, then hit quit. You can also use the Oculus mobile app to easily browse, buy, and download content to your account. Oculus Quest gives you the ability to cast, letting you share your headset's VR picture to a mobile phone or to a TV with a compatible casting-enabled device so your friends can see all the action. In order to cast, you'll need the Oculus app handy. Make sure your phone is on the same Wi-Fi network as your headset. Then, navigate to the Cast button on the top right of the App menu tab. Next, you'll be prompted to select which device you want to cast from and where you want to cast to. If you don't have a casting-enabled TV, you can cast to your mobile phone instead. Once you select which device to cast to, there will be a confirmation prompt in your headset. In VR, click Enable Casting. This will share your VR picture in real time. For more information on compatible devices, check out the Oculus support site. Creating an avatar is an important part of your experience. It's the virtual you that other VR users will see. Here's how to create yours. Select People from the navigation menu. Click on Profile. Then click Edit Avatar. Here, you can customize the appearance of your virtual self. You can select custom hair, eyes, facial features, clothes, and more. Or hit randomize to play around. Make sure to keep an eye out for newly added avatar item collections and items that you can unlock in games. While playing multiplayer games or simply hanging out in VR, you may want to join a voice call to stay connected to your friends. Here's how. First, you'll need to create a party with your friends. To do so, you'll need to add them to your friends list. Simply navigate to Add Friends and link your Facebook contacts or search for them by their full name or username. Once you have added your friend to your friends list, click the phone icon next to their name. After your friend accepts the invite notification in the Parties menu, you'll be able to hear their voice in your headset. Make sure that your mic is on and use headphones for the best audio experience. You'll be able to hear your friends in the main menu screen and in-game. Enjoy! To learn more about your Oculus Quest, you can watch more of this tutorial series or follow the Support Center link in the reference guide. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in VR.